Hachette Audio presents Law of Attraction, written and read by Michael J. Losier.
A brief history of the Law of Attraction. Some have heard reference to the Law of Attraction from various sources, while others are just beginning to learn about it. In modern times, the Law of Attraction has been documented since the early 1900s. Here's a brief history. In 1906, William Walter Atkinson wrote the book Thought Vibration, or The Law of Attraction in the Thought World. In 1926, Ernest Holmes wrote the book Basic Ideas of Science of Mind, and in 1949, Dr. Raymond Halliwell wrote the book Working with the Law. In the early 1990s, information and teachings on the Law of Attraction became widely available through the publications of Jerry and Esther Hicks. It is through their teachings that I really got it. Since 2000, many articles and books have been written about the Law of Attraction, and its appeal has expanded to a much broader audience. The future holds many more authors and teachers writing on this topic as the message of the Law of Attraction continues to grow in its mass appeal. What makes this audiobook different? In 1995, I studied NLP, Neuro-Linguistic Programming, to understand how our mind and thoughts work. This led me to many insights on how people learn. You'll notice, while listening to this audiobook, that it appeals to your and others' learning style. This audiobook is presented in such a way that each section builds on the last, and, as in any training manual, you can use the tools, exercises, and scripts to keep you connected to the Law of Attraction. Many of the books I've studied were broad in their theoretical approach to the subject of the Law of Attraction. Nowhere could I find an answer to my question, how do I actually do this? With my knowledge of NLP and how to teach using different learning styles, I created an easy-to-follow, how-to book for students of the Law of Attraction. Using the exercises and tools in this audiobook, you will be able to learn quickly so you can begin practicing the Law of Attraction in your own life. The most frequent and satisfying compliment I receive is that my method is simple to understand and the exercises are easy to follow. The book has been embraced by a multitude of different religious and spiritual groups. In addition, it has become required reading or listening for many sales groups, network marketing companies, realtors, financial advisors, and other business organizations. In short, this audiobook has mass appeal. You're already experiencing the Law of Attraction. Have you noticed that sometimes what you need just falls into place or comes to you from an out-of-the-blue telephone call? Or you've bumped into someone on the street you've been thinking about? Perhaps you've met the perfect client or life partner just by fate or being at the right place at the right time. All of these experiences are evidence of the Law of Attraction in your life. Have you heard about people who find themselves in bad relationships over and over again and who are always complaining that they keep attracting the same kind of relationship? The Law of Attraction is at work for them, too. The Law of Attraction may be defined as, I attract to my life whatever I give my attention, energy, and focus to, whether positive or negative. By listening to this audiobook, you'll come to understand why and how this happens. There are a number of words or expressions that describe evidence of the Law of Attraction. If you've ever used any of these words or expressions, you're actually referring to the Law of Attraction. Here are just a few. Out of the blue, fell into place, serendipity, synchronicity, coincidence, luck, fate, meant to be, and karma. In this audiobook, you'll learn why these experiences happen. More importantly, you'll discover how you can use the Law of Attraction more deliberately. You'll be able to attract all that you need to do, know, and have, so you can get more of what you want and less of what you don't. As a result, you'll have your ideal client, your ideal job, your ideal relationship, your ideal vacation, your ideal health, more money in your life, and all that you desire. Really? The science of the law of attraction. There is a physiological foundation for positive thinking and its effect in creating the law of attraction. There are many forms of energy: atomic, thermal, electromotive, kinetic, and potential. Energy can never be destroyed. You may also recall that all matter is made up of atoms, and that each atom has a nucleus containing protons and neutrons, around which orbit electrons. Electrons and atoms always orbit the nucleus in prescribed orbitals or energy levels that assure the stability of the atom. Electrons may be compelled to assume higher orbits by the addition of energy, or may give off energy when they drop to a lower orbit. When it comes to vibrations, if atoms are aligned, they create a motive force, all pulling together in the same direction, in much the same way as metals can be magnetized by aligning their molecules in the same direction. This creation of positive and negative poles is a fact of nature and science. Suffice to say, science has shown that if there are physical laws that can be observed and quantified in one arena, there are most probably similar laws in other arenas, even if they cannot be quantified at this time. So you see, the law of attraction isn't a fancy term or New Age magic. It's a law of nature that every atom of your being is in constant response to, whether you know it or not. Making reference to the law of attraction. Many authors have written about the law of attraction. Here are just a few of the many ways the law of attraction has been referred to in various books. That which is like unto itself is drawn. Jerry and Esther Hicks. The teachings of Abraham. Ask and it is given. What you radiate outward in your thoughts, feelings, mental pictures, and words, you attract into your life. Catherine Ponder, Dynamic Law of Prosperity. Never expect a thing you do not want, and never desire a thing you do not expect. When you expect something you do not want, you attract the undesirable, and when you desire a thing that is not expected, you simply dissipate valuable mental force. On the other hand, when you constantly expect that which you persistently desire, your ability to attract becomes irresistible. The mind is a magnet and attracts whatever corresponds to its ruling state. Dr. Raymond Hollowell, Working with the Law, 11 Truth Principles for Successful Living. Every thought must manifest according to its intensity. The slightest thought of intelligence sets in motion a power in the law to produce a corresponding thing. Ernest Holmes, Basic Ideas of Science of Mind. You are a living magnet. You attract into your life people, situations, and circumstances that are in harmony with your dominant thoughts. Whatever you dwell on in the conscious grows in your experience. Brian Tracy. Definition of the Law of Attraction. I attract to my life whatever I give my attention, energy, and focus to, whether positive or negative. Positive and negative vibrations. The word vibe is often used to describe a mood or a feeling that you pick up from someone or something. For example, you may say you pick up a good vibe when you are around a certain person. Or you may say that you get a negative vibe when you walk into a certain part of a neighborhood or city. In all of these cases, the word vibe is used to describe the mood or feeling you are experiencing. In short, a vibe equals a mood or a feeling. The word vibe comes from the longer word vibration, which isn't used often by most people. In the vibrational world, there's only two kinds of vibrations, positive and negative. Every mood or feeling causes you to emit, send out, or offer a vibration, whether positive or negative. If you go through the dictionary and select every...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.